Hey guys, welcome back. This video will explain how the aeroplane went to war, how it was used as an efficient scouting method or as a vehicle of attack. Stay tuned. Military aviation was in its infancy when the European powers went to war in August 1914, at the start of what we now know as the First World War. However, by the end of the war in 1918, the air had joined the land and the sea as a place in which men fought and died, and from which attacks were launched on both military and civilian targets. At the start of the war, the main combatant nations, Britain, France and Russia on one side, and Germany and Austro-Hungary on the other, could muster fewer than 500 serviceable aircraft for military or naval purposes. The military had one main use for these simple, initially unarmed and often unreliable biplanes and monoplanes: reconnaissance, finding out what the other side was doing. In this, aeroplanes were seen as an adjunct to the cavalry, the army's traditional scouting force, but as the conflict developed, they soon came to replace it and make a significant contribution of their own to the conduct of war. As the Germans advanced in Western Europe, the Allied armies were forced to retreat, but the information gathered by the aircraft helped them to halt the advance and launch counterattacks that forced the invaders back. This war of movement ended when neither side could get around the other and both were forced to dig defensive trench lines that by the window of 1914 to 1915 stretched from the English Channel to the Swiss border. For the next 3.5 years, as millions of soldiers became locked in the bitter, relentless struggle of trench warfare, only observers in aeroplanes and tethered balloons could effectively see and record what was happening along and across the Western Front. Reconnaissance aircraft such as the BE-2C were generally two-seaters, carrying a pilot and an observer. While the pilot concentrated on flying the aircraft, the observer gathered information. Initially, this was recorded by sketches, but from 1915, photography became the principal aerial reconnaissance technique. Whole sections of the trenches could be photographed in detail. These photographs were then joined together to form large photo mosaics, which could be interpreted for essential information or intelligence that was used both to determine the enemy's intentions and to plan attacks against them. A related task for aircraft and their crews was artillery spotting. Massive artillery barrages fired against the defensive positions both preceded and continued throughout offensives. They never achieved the decisive effect, however, until the return to more mobile warfare during 1918, the last year of the war, when they were used in conjunction with other means of assault, including low-flying, strafing, and bombing aircrafts. Aircraft observers could spot where artillery shells fell, and with the introduction of effective wireless transmitters from 1915, could communicate target coordinates by Morse code to the gunners, who then directed their fire accordingly. Intelligence gathered through photo reconnaissance had to be frequently updated, so patrols were flown every day alongside regular artillery spotting flights. Initially, the main threats faced by the aircraft crews came from the weather, fire from the ground, and the unreliability of their machines, but as they started to arm themselves first of all with rifles or hand-thrown bombs, and then machine guns, the war in the air became far more dangerous. In 1914, the Allies probably held the upper hand, but with the introduction of purpose-built fighter aircraft in 1915, the reconnaissance aircraft suffered as they flew on their steady patrol lines. 47 of the 80 aircraft destroyed by the German ace Manfred von Richthofen were engaged on reconnaissance duties. That's all for today. If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe. Stay tuned.